Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, you'll learn how to track your website conversions using goals in Google Analytics. We'll walk through how to identify goals and how to classify them into micro and macro conversions. We'll also cover how to assign value to your goal conversions and how to configure them inside Google Analytics. And since goals only report on conversions after you've configured them inside Google Analytics, I'll also show you how to report on previous conversions by applying a segment to your reports. Okay, let's get started. Once you've logged into your Google Analytics account, you'll need to start by selecting Admin on the bottom left corner. To configure goals in Google Analytics, you will need edit level permission for the reporting view. If you don't have edit permission, then you will be able to see if any goals have been configured, but you won't be able to add new goals or make changes to any existing goals. I'm currently in a Google Analytics web property, so we can see there are three columns. There is an account column on the left, then the property column in the middle, and the view column on the right. If you're using a Google Analytics app and web property, then you'll only see two columns, and you won't see the view column on the very right. If this is the case for your account, and you'd like to configure a goal, then check out my extra resources in the description below this video. Okay, so let's select Goals on the right. I haven't set up any goals in my demo account yet, so we can see it says there is no data for this view, and we can see we can create a new goal. If you have edit level permission, then you will be able to click the button, but if you don't have edit level permission, you won't be able to create a new goal. If this is the case for you, then you can either ask whoever manages your Google Analytics account to change your level of permission, or you could ask them to configure the goal for you. Let's select New Goal to configure a goal for our reporting view. First, we need to name our goal. I'm going to name this goal Email Subscriber. Next, we can select the Goal Slot ID. This is a way to group goals within your reports. There are four goal sets, and each goal set can contain up to five goals. Let's head to the Google Analytics demo account to see this. Now let's select Acquisition, then All Traffic, and Channels. The Google Analytics demo account has four goals configured, and they've all been created in a single goal set. So at the top of the report, we can see Goal Set 1. We can then select this goal set to see the conversion rate for each of the goals that have been configured. If additional goals were configured using the other three goal sets, then these goal sets would appear as additional tabs at the top of the report. We would then see Goal Set 2, Goal Set 3, and Goal Set 4. So the goal sets simply group goals together in our reports. They don't impact the way goals are tracked or reported. Now let's head back to our goal configuration. For my goal, I'm going to leave the default goal slot, but remember you can change this if you like. Next, we need to select the goal type. We can choose from destination, duration, pages or screens per session, event, and Smart Goal if it's available. Let's run through these options. Destination or page-based goals let you report a conversion when someone reaches a particular page on your website. This is the most common type of goal people configure inside Google Analytics. It's typically used for people viewing a thank you page. For example, to report on the number of people who complete your email sign-up form and then view the confirmation or thank you page after they've successfully entered their details. Next are engagement-based goals. These are duration and pages or screens per session. These let us count a conversion after someone spends a certain amount of time on our website or views a certain number of pages. The next option is an event-based goal. This type of goal requires that you are already tracking events into Google Analytics. You can use events to track actions taking place within the pages of your website. For example, people watching a video or downloading a PDF. So to configure this type of goal, you'll need to set up event tracking first. You can then enter the event category action, or label, or any combination of these to count a conversion in your reports. To learn more about event tracking, take a moment to check out the extra resources in the description below this video. Finally, there are smart goals. This type of goal will automatically count conversions for the most engaged users on your website. You'll need to have Google Ads linked to Google Analytics and at least 500 clicks from your ads for this option to be available. It uses Google's machine learning to determine if a conversion should be counted. I'd only use this option if you can't configure a destination or event goal, or you're unable to implement e-commerce tracking. Since I don't have Google Ads linked to Google Analytics in my demo account, this option isn't available. I'm going to be creating a goal for people signing up to receive my email updates. When people sign up, they're taken to a thank you page on my website. So I'm going to select destination as the goal type. Now let's click continue. We now have to enter the destination page on our website. This is the final thank you or conversion page people see after they've converted. If you already know the URL for your thank you page, then you can enter it into the field. Otherwise, a good way to find this is to head to your website and complete the process yourself. So let's head to my website. And we can see the form that people sign up to receive my email updates. So the first thing we can do is make a note of the URL. Now let's complete the form. We're now on the thank you page, so I can make a note of the URL people see once they've converted. Okay, let's head back to Google Analytics. I can now enter the URL of the thank you page as the destination for my goal. Now we only need to enter the page, so we don't need to include our website's domain. So I'm going to modify this, so it's everything after my domain. To the left, we can see it says equals to. This option means that the URL of the page we enter will need to exactly match to the one someone views in order for a conversion to be counted. For example, if we enter /thank you, it's only going to match that particular page. It is not going to match pages with additional details before or after the page. So thank you, ID equals 563, and thank you, ID equals 892, will not be matched. It's only going to match exactly what's entered. And we can select this option to then change the way pages are matched for our goal. We could then choose begins with. This will match your URLs with or without query parameters. So /thank you will match thank you ID equals 563, and thank you status equals true. And we could select regular expression, which is an advanced matching option. For example, you can use regular expression matching to match multiple thank you pages in a single goal. If you'd like to learn more about regular expressions, then check out the extra resources in the description below this video. I'm going to select begins with for my goal. The next step is to enter a conversion value. This is optional, but I always recommend trying to add a value for the goals you configure in Google Analytics. You can use a real, calculated, or symbolic value. Let's say your goal is for people registering to attend an event, and that event has a fixed price. You could enter the transaction value, so the value would be the actual or real value for the conversion. The one thing to highlight is that unless the conversion is for a fixed value, like in my example, you might want to consider using e-commerce tracking instead of a goal. The next option is to use a calculated value. This is commonly used for websites generating leads. For example, if you had a consulting business and you had a contact form where you were trying to get people to connect with you for consulting projects. Not every single person completing the form is going to end up being a client or a customer. But what we can do is we can do a rough calculation to understand the average value of each of the leads. And we also have the option of using a symbolic value. This is useful if we're not trying to generate actual revenue or where it's difficult to calculate the value. So we use a guesstimate to rank the importance of our different conversion actions inside Google Analytics. From there, we can now enter our funnel steps that lead to our thank you or conversion page. I'm going to name the step and define the URL of the page for the step. I recommend leaving required to know, as this only alters the older funnel visualization report inside Google Analytics. In the majority of cases, you really don't need to turn this option on. You can define up to 20 funnel steps for your goal by selecting Add Another Step. Google Analytics also gives you the ability to preview the goal conversion rate before you save the goal. This is a good way to check that your goal configuration works, since you'll only see conversions reported after you save the goal. Goals won't provide historical conversion data. You can click on Verify this goal to make sure the goal conversion rate is what you'd expect, and then you can click Save. We've now configured a goal inside Google Analytics. Since goals start to track conversions into our reports after they've been configured, let's look at how we can view historical conversions. Let's head to our reports. I'm going to head back to the Google Analytics demo account. We've seen that destination goals are based on our thank you page, so let's head to the page's report. Let's select Behavior, then Site Content, and All Pages. Now let's search for /registersuccess.html as our thank you page. We can now look at the Unique Page Views column to understand how many historical conversions we've received, and we have the option of adjusting our date range too. This is one way to view your historical conversions. Now I want to show you how you can create a custom report to quickly see the total number of historical conversions. Let's select Customization and then Custom Reports. And let's create a new custom report. I'm going to name the report Historical Conversions. And let's add a metric. I'm going to add Unique Page Views. And now let's add a dimension. I'm going to add page. Now let's select Add Filter. And search for and select page. Now let's enter /registersuccess.html. And let's save the report. We can now see the total number of historical conversions for our goal. Apart from searching in our reports and creating a custom report, we can also create a custom segment to view historical conversions too. The nice thing about segments is that we can apply them to different reports. So let's select Add Segment. Now let's click New Segment. Let's name the segment Conversions. And let's select Sequences. There are different ways you can create segments, but let's keep things simple today. I'm going to leave the default options selected at the top, and then I'm going to select Page for step 1. I'm then going to select Exactly Matches. And I'm going to enter the URL for the page that people need to view before they convert. For the Google Store demo account, I'm going to enter /signin.html. Then I'm going to click Add Step. I'm going to select Page and Exactly Matches. And I'm going to enter the conversion page. I'm going to enter /registersuccess.html. Now I can click Save. The numbers might be slightly different since our segment doesn't work in the exact same way as goals do in Google Analytics, but the number of conversions should be fairly accurate. Now we can head to different reports in Google Analytics, and our conversion segment will continue to be applied. For example, let's select Acquisition, then All Traffic, and Channels. We can now see how people found our website before they converted. And since it's a segment, we can even modify the date range to look further back in time. Before we wrap up, I want to mention that it's important to take some time to think about the different actions you want people to take on your website. You can then classify these actions as macro and micro conversions. Think of macro conversions as your primary objectives. They're going to be the actions that drive the most value for you and your organization. For example, leads, purchases, members and bookings could be examples of macro conversions. Then you can think of micro conversions as secondary objectives. These will be actions that show a high level of engagement but don't provide the same value as macro conversions. Examples of micro conversions could include people entering their details to download a PDF, subscribing to your email updates, commenting, or logging into a members area. Once you've categorized actions as micro and macro conversions, you can then configure them as goals in Google Analytics. So that's how you can track conversions using goals in Google Analytics. Remember, it's important to assign a value to each goal you configure so you can see values included in your reports. If you want to learn more about Google Analytics, then join me in my Google Analytics course, where you'll learn practical skills for using your reports and techniques for configuring Google Analytics. You can find a link to join the course in the description below this video. Are you tracking conversions? Do you have any tips you'd like to add? Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please subscribe, share it with your friends, and hit the like button so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.